KSSH News at Noon. I'm Jamie Spector, and this is my co-anchor, Amelia Wilbur.
Thanks, Jamie.
Well, folks, only 204 more hours before we're out of here.
Yeah, but who's counting?
Well, about 1,500 students and teachers.
Hey, Santa Sue, I'm Emma Saturday, and I'm here with another new teacher, Miss Chrissy Offit. So, Miss Offit, how are you liking Santa Sue so far?
Oh, Emma, I'm so glad you asked. Santa Sue's great. I went to the tech rehearsal for the choir performance, and it was amazing. I'm just continually blown away by how talented everybody is at the school, and the staff is great. So far, so good.
How is Santa Sue different than other schools you've taught at?
I've never taught before, so it's not very different. Now, this is my first job as a teacher. I'm a first-year teacher. I actually retired from the production business. I worked for 20 years in video and film production. This is my first job as a teacher, so I'm really happy to be here.
What do you like to do on the weekends or in your spare time?
Well, I have a very active social life, Emma. Thanks for asking. I am a roller derby referee for the Los Angeles Derby Dolls, and I play the ukulele, and I have a dog who I really, really like a lot, and I'm still getting my credentials settled, so I'm still going to continuing education classes for teaching, so that keeps me pretty busy too, but roller derby, the dog, the ukulele, it's good times.
Well, Mrs. Offit, thank you so much for your time.
Oh, I'm sorry, Emma, were you talking to me? My bad.
Thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome for my time.
No, I prefer not to.
Hey, Santa Sue, I'm Sarah Hall here with Mr. Scheinberg. So, Mr. Scheinberg, tell us about the Vex Robotics Club.
Well, a group of students came to me earlier this year asking if they could have an enhanced hands-on science and technology program. They recommended that we start a Vex Robotics competition team, and so we started fundraising and organizing, and we received a grant kit, and we have a robot that's going to a competition in December.
So what does the Vex Robotics competition do?
Well, it's an international competition where junior high school, and colleges get together every year, and they build robots to perform certain tasks. For example, this year the competition is called Sack Attack, where the goal is for the robots to go and pick up little bean bags and place them in different scoring zones. And the faster you can do that, the higher your score.
So how do you earn all the money for the equipment?
Well, we've been writing grants. We received $1,200 worth of robotics equipment already. We have a stocking stuffer robot that we're selling for Christmas, these little hex bugs, while supplies last, $10 in room 101, and whatever proceeds we get from this go directly to benefit the club and the students who go to the competitions. In addition, we still have more grants that we are writing to try to get additional robotics equipment so that more students can participate.
Back to you in the studio.
And now, a word about our upcoming instrumental concert.
And what would you like for Christmas, little boy?
I want tickets to An American Winter.
The dance concert is almost upon us. It's tomorrow! Gifts for Christmas is the fun part. Finding the money to buy them is the hard part.
Hey, Santa Sue. Kelly Lolliker here. Buying presents can get pretty costly, but lucky for you, I have some helpful tips to stretch your dollar.
You can bake cookies or do a gift exchange with your friends or get them something personal that you can both enjoy, because really, it's the thought that counts.
Santa Claus is coming to
or make them a friendship bracelet.
I have no idea what to get my little brother for the holidays. Well, here's an option.
Hey Sansu, Anthony Heller here, on my way to the Los Angeles Auto Show in downtown LA at the Convention Center. Going to search for presents.
Forget about your Hemis and your GTOs. I've got a new machine, and she really goes. When I pass you on the drag strip, you'll know darn well. Been beaten by a porcupine, V8 Chevelle. Tagging it up now, you better be quick. Nothing can outrun my SS-396.
Now that, parents, is my holiday list.
I hope my parents see that. You've got a better chance of winning a car in a contest.
We're here to talk about the car giveaway.
We have an insurance company in town, Horace Mann. They're donating a car this year to the high schools.
I'm here with Tyler Likes from Horace Mann Insurance. So why has your insurance company come to Sansu?
Well, we've heard a lot of great things about Sansu. We're involved in all the schools in the district, and we're helping to boost attendance and test scores with our car giveaway.
Well, the car is a beautiful white Ford Focus, 2013. It's currently parked on Royal High School's campus. It's going to come here, and then it's also going to go to CME. So it'll be here for a few days so you can see it.
How were you able to give away this car?
So all these different local businesses are kind of pulling together to help out education in CME Valley.
Likely we'll be doing something based around grades, star scores, attendance, and possibly even citizenship. So we haven't quite finalize that, but those are the four areas that we're really thinking about, and we'll start passing out tickets second semester.
So after we receive the ticket, what happens?
When you get the ticket, you fill out your entry form, and then you're going to go online to register.
They're having one car between the three high schools, but next year, the same company is going to be doing one car per high school, which is pretty awesome.
Back to you in the studio.
I got the Letterman sweater with the letter in front. I got the football and track. Wait, we don't have football or track, but we do have sweaters. Here's Wesley Cole.
With a new sweater in the minds of our students, one can't help but ask, to buy or not to buy?
Can you tell us a little bit more about the sweaters?
Sure. We've been talking about trying to give our students something to have that's sort of a unifying factor and for our campus. And the sweater was something that we came up with because it's different and unique, like our student body.
So how do you feel about that cardigan?
I haven't seen it personally, but I have looked at it in a picture, but I'm probably gonna get one just because it's senior year and it looks pretty cool to me.
They're actually pretty snazzy, you know, very stylish. I like them.
So there's been a lot of talk about the price of the sweaters. How do you feel about that?
Well, I know that they're expensive. We got three quotes. This is the cheapest quote by over $40. And I know that $140 seems like a lot, but this is sort of a lifelong memento that you'll have. They're super high quality, they're handmade, and you know, it's kind of an investment for you know, your years here at Sansu, and it is really a memento that you'll keep with you. The school's not making a dime, literally, on the sweaters. We're selling them for exactly what the company is charging us to the student body, because we want as many students to have them as possible.
How do you feel about the price?
The price is a little too high for me, personally.
It is a little pricey, but it's whatever. I'm gonna get one anyway.
It's good, but I'm probably gonna have to pay out of it from my own pocket, so I'm kind of 50-50 about buying it.
I really like it, but I can't afford it.
$140, Yorick.
Yeah, not gonna happen.
No.
Nope.
Well, you heard it here. The students say it's a bit pricey, but they like the appearance, and the administration says it's a great opportunity for students to gain spirit and have a memory when they grow up.
Back to you in the studio.
Santa Susana is all about individuality and expressing who you are. We do that by what we wear, how we act, and of course, by the fluorescent colors we dye our hair.
Hey Santa Sue, it's Amelia and Jamie. Have you noticed that a lot of students here have really vibrant colored hair? That's why I'm here to talk to a few of them to see just why they did it.
I decided to dye my hair because I was bored with my natural hair color.
I decided to dye my hair red because I'm very into the flame motive, and I've tried every other color, and none of them seem to work, but the flame just really seemed to go with my skin tone, so.
What did your friends think?
Well, nobody really reacted. They just thought it was really cool.
The reactions I got from people is I've been called Little Red and Flamehead, and I really like the attention I'm getting for it.
Are there any other colors you would consider dyeing your hair?
I would like to put orange in my hair.
I love the different hair colors. Go for it!
Back to you in the studio.
Is it true that blondes have more fun? How would I know? And what does that have to do with this next story?
Hey students, Jessica Francides here. Finals begin the week after we get back from break. If that thought scares you, you might want to start getting tutored to prepare for them. The tutors are here to help.
I'm here with CSF President Eric Joe for more information.
The California Scholarship Federation is a student-run organization that promotes community service and scholarship among its members. One of its major functions is that it offers a peer tutoring program here on campus. This program is entirely free. Anybody can come in and be tutored without any charge. All the basic academic classes are covered. It's offered every day of the week. If you feel like you need help in a class, you should consider using this program. There are forms in Mrs. Hazelwood's room 401. Fill it out and turn it in to Mrs. Hazelwood. You will get notified of the days that you can come. Also, if you've done really well in your previous classes, you should consider volunteering as a tutor. It counts as community service, and it looks really good on your college application.
I'm here with Amanda Smith, one of the tutors. So what subject are you best at?
I tutor in geometry at CSF.
I'm here with Chelsea Espiritu, one of the students being tutored.
I'm being helped in Math Algebra 1.
Are you seeing results in your scores after being in the program?
Yes, I have. My scores are actually like a bit better than before. I'm not failing.
Don't forget to buy your significant other a Jinglegram. Available now in the student store, and proceeds go to the Make-A-Wish Foundation. I do believe we have an activity day in exactly 1 week, so dress accordingly. And that's the way it is. December 13th, 2012. Have a great day, Santa Sue.
I know you belong to someone.